It's old-fashioned. Charlie, you're the animal salesman. Does your firm get credit?
No, sir.
Nor anybody else.
Reverse city! Reverse city! Next!
Cash for the merchandise. Cash for the button hooks.
Cash for the cotton goods. Cash for the hard goods.
Cash for the soft goods. Cash for the fancy goods.
Cash for the noggins and the piglins and the purples.
Cash for the hogshead. Cash for the dingy joint. Cash for the peckers and the pickles and the fly pair.
Look, what are you talking?
You can talk, you can talk. You can bicker, you can talk. You can bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk, you can talk. You can talk. Bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk all you want, but it's different than it was.
No, it ain't. But you got to know the territory.
Shh, 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 shh,
shh, shh. Why, Model T Ford been in trouble, man. The people want to go. Want to get money. Get up and go. 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 22, 23 miles to the county seat.
Yes, sir.
Who's going to patronize a little bit of 2x4 at a store anymore?
What are you talking? What did you get?
Not the Model T at all. Take a candle at the store, at the margarine store, at the Pleasant Day store.
No, it didn't,
but you gotta know the territory.
Gone with the hogshead, Cassie and Dibby John. Gone with the sugar barrel, pickle barrel, milk can. Gone with the tub and the pail and the tears.
Ever met a fellow by the name of Hill?
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 No!
Just a minute.
Never heard of any salesman, Hill.
Now he doesn't know the territory.
Doesn't know the territory? What's the fellow's line?
Never worries about his line. Boy, the cracker barrel.
Just a minute.
Never worries about his line. Or a doggone thing. He's just a bangy, bell ringing, big call, great bell, wrist, horn, neck, and nothing. Every time a bull's like him.
What's his line?
He's a bank, and he doesn't know the territory.
What are you talking?
He's a music man.
He's a what?
He's a music man. He sells clarinets to the kids in the town, the big trombones, and the ragtag drums, big brass bass. And the piccolo, beautiful, shiny gold braid on the hook, and a big red
strap. Well, I don't know much about bands, but I do know you can't make a living selling big trombones. No, sir. Mandolin picks, perhaps, and here and there a Jew's harp.
No, the fellow's a band. Boy band. I don't know how he does it, but he lives like a king. Galley gets together, flex and he shines. Women and dances, certain boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Women, dances, certain boys, what else? The piper pays him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he doesn't know the territory.
Well, it won't be on this trip. Not in Iowa. Even great Harold Hill wouldn't try.
try to sell them neckload Hawkeye right here.
Board! All aboard!
Gentlemen, you intrigue me. I do believe I'll have to buy a wet ride.
Don't believe I saw your name.
I don't believe I dropped it.
Thank you.
McGriff.
Professor Hill's the name. Harold Hill.
McGriff, what are you doing here? Why didn't you let me know you was coming?
Well, I didn't know I was myself. Besides, you were a pretty big slicker back when you were in business with me.
Too many close shaves for what you were. Besides, I gotta be a nice, comfortable girl. That's the top of my boss's voice.
You gone legitimate, huh? I should have known you were up to no good.
So, what's the new pitch? You're not back in the van business. I heard you was a steam automobile.
Well, it was.
What happened?
Somebody actually invented one.
No.
Yep. No. Give me the lowdown here, Mars.
You'll never get anywhere in the van business to be stuck up high ones, Greg. Besides, we got a music teacher here who'll expose you before you get your grip unpacked.
Male or female?
Music teacher? She's a librarian. Female.
Perfect. It's just what I wanted to hear. Make sure you point her out to see her.
I will. How are you going to start the pitch?
Oh, the same old way. I'm going to keep that music teacher off her balance. And my next step will be to get your town out of serious trouble, it's in.
But River City isn't in any trouble.
Well, then I'll have to create some. Remember, I have to create a desperate need for a boys band. You remember. Now, what's new around here? What can I use?
Oh, such a bigger part just put in a new pool table.
They never had a pool table before?
No, only billiards.
You know, that's gonna work. Thanks, Mark, and remember, music teacher.
Music.
That's right. Sir, are you Mr. Dunlop?
Yeah.
Well, either you're closing your eyes to a situation we do not wish for a knowledge, or you're unaware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, say trouble right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a good friend. Certainly mine, I'm proud to say. I'm always mine, I'm proud to say. I consider that the hours I spend with a Q in my hand are golden. Cold space 4-6, and a cool head, and a keen eye. Did you ever take a try to get an ironclad sheet and sell them from a 3-round village yet? Well, just as I say, it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to score in a fog line game. I say that any boom can take and shove a ball in a pocket. I call that slot the first big step on the road to the depths of Deus Ex Machina. Medicinal wine from the distance, then beer from pot. And the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in a pitchback suit. And listen, some big ass down Jasper appeared to tell about horse race gambling. Not a wholesome truck race, no, but a race where they sit down right on the horse. Like to see some stuck up jockey boy sitting on Dan's hat. Make blood boil. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 clocks in a day. Clocks that mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum. The capital B, that rhyme with B, and that stands for pool. And all week long, your River City youth will be frittering. And I said, your young youth will be frittering. Frittering away their youth on summertime joy time too. Get the ball in the pocket, never mind, get dandelions picked to the screen door, patch the speech they counted. Never mind pumping any water to the parents or cop with the sister and dancing on a Saturday night, and that's trouble. And lots of trouble. Talking about kids in a knickerbocker shirt to a young one. Speaking in that pool hall, when you're out of school, you got trouble, folks. Right here in River City. Trouble with a capital T that rhymes with B and that stands for pool. Now I know all you folks who write young parents. I'm gonna be perfectly frank. Would you like to know what kind of conversation goes on when they're open around that hall? They'll be trying out Viva, trying out Cuba, trying out Taylor, maybe by cigarette beef. And bragging all about how they're gonna cover up a mail cell right with Simpson one fine night. They'll leave the pool hall and for the dance of the armor. Liberty men, Charlie women, and red. Mothers of River City, heed the warning before it's too late. Many doors stunned, leave the house. To see green bubbles and chuckers, blow the jeans. Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? There's a dime novel hidden in the corn crib. Is he starting to write jokes out of Cap Billy's whiz bang? Are certain words start to creep into his conversation? Words like swell.
Oh!
Oh! A social man?
Oh!
Well, no, my friend. You got trouble.
Oh, we got trouble.
In the city.
I can see.
But the capital of P, that bond with B, that stands for fool.
That stands for fool.
We surely got trouble.
We surely got trouble.
In the city.
Right here.
Remember the main, Plymouth Rock, and the Golden Rule.
Our children, children, gonna have trouble.
Oh, we got trouble. We're serious, serious. Thank you.
He's ashamed.
We know all about his sister, Bertha. Well, what's wrong?
No, thank you, Amarillis! Amarillis! He's crying! Why did he get so mad at me? Just because he lives.
It's not only because he lives, Amarillis. That's just part of it.
What's the other part?
Never mind, dear. It's just that he never talks very much.
Not even to you and your mother?
No. We all have to be a little patient.
Rayleigh McKenzie Shin for leading the music. And to J.C. Squire for his fine stereo twin slide. As mayor of River City, I welcome all you River Cityans to the 4th of July festivities here on the square. For school! Some disagreement about the costumes, I suppose. Instead, the Watan Yigu of the local wigwam, Hiawatha, will present a spectacle, My Wife, in which, My Wife, Yuvaley McKechnie Shin will take leading part.
Right.
shine trumpets. Ta-ta-da-da! You'll feel something, akin to the electric thrill I want to enjoy. Liberace, Pat Harmon, WCN, the great Cleotoy, and John Philip Sousa all came to town on the very same short day. 76 trombones led a big parade with 110 cornets right behind. There were more than 1,000 wreaths bringing up the white queens. There were of every shape and kind. 76 trombones got the morning sun with 110 cornets right behind. There were more by rows and rows of the finest virtue books. So the free of everything is then. There were couple fun and infinite and arms of men. Not to bring the real all on the way. Double bell.
Zanita, I'm Heavy, I think you're checking me. Yeah.
Zanita, do you know Dominic? All right, Tommy, this here's a need. Escort the young lady home.
All he accepts I'm not going. I have to go to the library. He can't.
Well, then escort her home by way of the library. By way of the candy kitchen.
Yes, sir. Do I have to?
Oh, you have to, Tommy.
Yes, sir.
He can.
Professor, you're a pretty bright young fellow. But you made a couple mistakes.
Oh?
You see, the mayor owns that very department. And the new full day.
Well, what was my other one?
That's Anita. She's the mayor's oldest girl.
Excuse me, Professor. We'd like to have your credentials. We're the school board.
Academic certificates.
Nothing of the kind.
Bring these letters.
Make him put up the phone.
Wait. Put him on here. You, sir. You say.
I scream, but I don't sing it. That's.
All right, sir. Top it down.
I scream.
That's good. That is good. Now, talk slow.
I scream.
Good. Now, look. Singing is only the same top. Now, you, sir.
I scream.
You, sir.
I scream.
You go by.
I scream.
Ladies, from now on, you are never going to see one of those four men without you.
From Gary, Indiana.
Well, even if that should happen to be true, Is that given the right to follow me around wherever I go? And another thing, Mr. Hill, I'm not easy mesmerized, but hoodwinked as some of the people in this town. And I think it only fair to warn you, I have a shelf full of reference books in there. They very well give me some interesting information about you.
For a minute there, even I thought you knew something about leading a boys' band, just like you used to imitate that concert fellow back in Joplin.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, that's good stuff. I'm in rare form nowadays. You keep your eyes on me for the next 4 weeks.
4 weeks? It used to only take 10 days for the instruments to arrive.
Well, it still does, but it takes 4 weeks for the uniform.
Oh, no. You haven't added uniform.
Mm-hmm. Uniforms and instruction books.
Instruction books? But you can't pass yourself off as a music professor. I mean, not for any 4 weeks.
Mars.
You don't know one note from another.
Well, I have this revolutionary new method. It's called Think System. Don't bother with notes.
But in 4 weeks, the people will want to hear music. You'll actually have to lead a band.
Well, these apples are really good. If you're ever going to get an apple, get them right there at Dunlop.
All right, I will.
But anyway. Yes, in 4 weeks they are going to want to hear notes. But whenever those band uniforms arrive, forget about everything else. Now, I have this time down to the last wave of the brakeman's hand on the last train out of town. See, this is a refined operation, Mr. Washburn. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Gonna line yourself up in a little canoe one, eh?
Well...
Say, I can fix you up with that sister. Lovely girl. Teaches Sunday school.
Sunday school? No wide-eyed, wholesome, eager Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of girl spins webs, no spider. Are you listening to me?
Oh, I'm listening.
All right. That girl simply wants to trade all her purity for my independence and her security.
Oh, Professor Hill, we're all agog, simply agog. On the QV.
I'm so excited for the band. I'm Ethel Topham, the pianola girl,
and this is Mrs. Squires and Mrs. Hicks. And of course you met Eulalie McKechnie Shin, our mayor's wife. Oh, isn't it exciting, Eulalie?
I couldn't say. I could not say. Oh no, I couldn't say this time. My husband will wish to investigate.
And naturally,
I'm reticent. Oh yes, I'm reticent.
Oh, I understand completely, Miss Shin. But part of my plans include a dance committee and... Your foot. What you just did right now?
Oh, I just have a bunion that bothers me.
Oh, what great. What natural flow of rhythm.
Why, Mr. Hill.
Oh, ladies, she must accept chairmanship of the ladies' auxiliary, mustn't she?
Oh, yes. Eulalie McKechnie Shin. That is dancing?
And you accept?
Well, yes, indeed. And let me just say that I...
And the young lady who plays the piano, Miss, Peru, I believe?
Ooh.
After all, she's a librarian, right?
Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, cheek, cheek, cheek. Talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little.
Take care and teeth, she has golden glint in her eyes, and a silver voice coming out of mid-range at night.
I'm only going to be in town for a short while, and... well, this happened for a while ago to me.
Will you please make your selection and leave?
But I already have.
Well, what do you want to take out?
The librarian!
Quiet, please!
The librarian? You're not listening to me, Marion. Look! Marion Marbles! Six steelies, eight addies, a dozen peewees, and one big glass with an American flag in the middle. I think I'll drop them.
No!
Thank you. Okay, Professor.
Bye.
Thanks, Tommy.
Just a minute. Are you soliciting? You haven't got a license.
Me? No, Mayor Shin. I was just collecting, looking. I was looking at that door bell. Yes, that door bell. See that door bell? I was looking at it because I collect door bells. That door bell has a very unique tone call that when you strike it,
loudly will not tell you. Soliciting is statutory in this county. Mouthpiece is without a permit. Why haven't you been testing all your records?
Just missed you. Mayor, Shin, your hand.
What? What?
That's right, a little finger. That's a red shirt.
Oh, it is? What does that mean?
That means that your son's little finger is perfectly situated to operate this fit valve on a B-flat flugelhorn. Is that good? Oh, that's great. That means that America has at last produced a young artist who can flugel the minute waltz in 50 seconds.
How can I get one of those horns?
Oh, you just sign right here, Mr. Mayor. Fine, fine. It's going to be $17 in forfeit.
Just think, I could have missed this hope. Just a minute. I haven't gotten it, son. You be down City Hall with your doggone papers by 3:00.
Whoa, you mean this afternoon?
I couldn't make myself any plainer if I was a Quaker on his day off.
I'm going to go get
against one of the boy's father besides.
The boy's father is dead. Anything else?
I'm sorry. But that's all the more reason why your little brother needs something like this.
My brother is an 8-year-old problem child who can't understand why his father was taken away. Would you care to explain it to him? He's been brooding about it for 2 years. And now she needs to go tricks. Why don't you go to visit some nice carnival man who sells gold-painted watches and black diamond rings?
Musical tricks? Why, Miss Peru, I... You know, I think she likes the idea. A little cautious. Yes, perhaps a little cautious, but hey, I like that Norman. Now, keep me alive, and I'll be back later in the week.
Oh, Professor, I do hope you'll excuse Mary. She's not there yet.
Oh, I'm sure. But at heart, she's as lovely as herself. Good day to you, Widow Peru.
Gone? He has, and I hope not forever. Don't you ever think of your future, darling? Gary, Indiana, conservation class of 05. Now, darling?
Now, Mom, surely a girl's beauty doesn't depend on encouraging every fast-talking, self-centered, woman-chasing traveling man who comes to town. In fact, any claims to commodity beauty is not this particular face impressive.
All right, darling, all right. But it's a well-known principle if you keep the flint in one drawer and the steel in the other, you're never going to strike much of a fire.
Mom! Winthrop? Winthrop, is that you? Winthrop, I know you're there. Please go to the library and ask Miss Grubbs to read the book I picked up. The Indiana State Educational Journal, 1800 to 1910. It's a large brown volume with black corners.
Do I have to?
You don't have to say anything. I've written it all down. Thank you, dear.
Now what are you up to? Why do you need books at this hour of the night?
I'm feeling the Indiana Journal may have put some rather large holes in the professor's claim.
Well, I give up. And curate, if you don't mind my asking, what kind of white knight do you expect to come riding along?
Well, I'm not going to Luther Grimes, who backs the invention history show every time he comes to the library.
He does.
Or Ed Gainbridge, and that buggy of his with the removable back seat. But I'm not waiting for a knight to turn one over either.
Bye.
lumberyard, and now the footbridge. And where will you meet me after that? The black hole, Calcutta? He can!
I don't want to show you my new invention.
What invention?
A music holder for a marching piccolo player. It still has a couple of minor flaws. See, when you keep it tight enough to hold the music steady, you cut off circulation, you can't wiggle your fingers. Meanwhile, could go blind.
Tommy, it's Papa!
Is that the first thing I said or not?
Yes, George.
Yes, the very first thing I said, or Ollie came with a horse. Give me that spellbinder credentials, I said, morning of July 4th, 1912. And now, my wife is off dancing at any and all hours instead of in the home.
But George!
The school board is seeing up street down alley instead of tending to city matters. My oldest girl is off googling around with some wild kid, and my business has fallen off so far, I can't even find the balance sheet.
Mayor Shinton, I found something very interesting in this book about Professor Hill's alma mater.
His who?
His university.
Oh, I know all about that. In fact, that's all I can ever get out of him. Gary Conservatory, class of walk by.
But if you'll just take some time to read a little bit about the conservatory, I don't think you have to look any further. It's on page...
Papa, the Wells Fargo wagon's just coming up from the depot.
The Wells Fargo wagon?
I like this story. At this hour of the day, nonsense. The Wells Fargo wagon?
It could be the band instrument.
I bet it's the band instrument. Now, Miss Marion, about that book.
George, fugitive.
You watch your phraseology. Get along if you didn't have to. I need to get something from the librarian. About that book.
The ladies' dance committee meets Tuesday nights at the high school.
Thank you. Tells me about some
think system? If he thinks the minuet in D, he won't have to bother with the notes? Now, Professor...
Miss Marion, I have to admit, the think system is a revolutionary new method. But so is Galileo's concept of the heavens, Columbus's concept of the egg, no, globe, Bach's concept of the habichord. Now, I'd like to discuss this with you further, but not here in public. When may I call upon you?
Why not this week?
Just all of the grand. see, I got the good argument today.
That swindling tube is a lawyer. That's why I got this shit.
Our number 8 only makes a 20-minute water stop.
Sure wish it was 25. Sure would like to punch it 5 minutes on you, little girl.
Who are you?
Name's Charlie Cow. Handlesome. But just now I'm about to take the good name of the traveling fraternity from this one.
Mr. Cow, you're making a big mistake.
Mistake in my old lady's corset cover. That fellow's been the raspberry seed in my wizard for just long enough. He spoiled Illinois for me, and he's not gonna spoil Iowa. Say, what kind of music teacher are you anyway? You didn't see through him? Why, he's no more professor.
Oh, I know all about that. Band leaders are always called professor. It's a harmless deception. He's a fine director, and his scholastic...
Now, wait a minute. Fine director? Tell me this. Have you heard a single note of music from any band?
No, but...
But nothing, girly girl. That man has never formed a band in his life, and he never will.
If you'll just listen to me for a minute.
I'd like to, girly girl, if I had the time. I sure got the inclination. But I gotta get back to my train, and I gotta leave this dynamite with somebody on the way to the depot. Bye, girly girl. See you next time, sir.
You'll never make that train to the depot. You'll have to catch this crossing.
No, sir. I gotta leave word, and I can see that you ain't the one to leave it with.
Just a minute, Mr. Cow. You don't know me yet.
Is, that an invitation?
No, I mean, I don't know you, and...
I need more time anyway.
I mean, as well as I'd like to.
No trouble there, girly girl.
I never met a man who sells anvils before. There's something, well, quite exciting.
Well, takes a real salesman, I can tell you that. Anvils have a limited appeal, you know. What am I doing? I missed that train and I'll get fired, and I gotta leave word about that fellow Hill.
Leave word with me.
Not on your tin top. How do I know that you deliver these letters?
Try to.
Are you okay?
There's your train, now run for it.
What are you double dealing, little? Who do you think you're protecting? Well, that guy's got a girl in every county in Illinois, and that's 102 counties. Why does that count the piano teachers like you that you boosted up to keep your mouth shut? Neither one of you show the last of me, girl and girl.
Are only the teachers in
said something wrong?
Please don't let me keep you, Professor Dillon. I'm sure you have many more important things to do than explain the think system to me. And I must be very ill company for men of your experience.
Now, say, what gives you ideas like that?
One hears rumors of crowded cells.
One also hears rumors about librarians.
I suppose you're referring to Uncle Maddie.
Uncle Maddie?
Mr. Madison, my father's best friend. No matter what they say, he left me an assured job. So Mother and Withip and I would have some security. Surely you don't believe.
Of course not. But that's what I'm saying. Why do you think people start rumors?
Narrow-mindedness? Jealousy? Jealousy mostly, I guess.
Exactly. And jealousy mostly starts rumors about traveling salesmen. What have you heard?
Nothing about you. Personally, just generally.
And what have you heard generally?
Just that. But of course, it stands to reason that, narrow-mindedness and jealousy can lead to, well, we'll take you for instance. Your attention to customers and teachers, well, they might easily be misinterpreted now, might they? And so you say if another salesman or somebody were jealous, well, they could speak down my boss, now couldn't they?
What could?
Rumors and things.
Oh, of course.
It just goes to show you should never believe everything you hear. I mean, if you just discuss things.
Miss Marion, I would be delighted to discuss anything in the world with you. But can't we do it sitting down? Your knees bend, right? You just sit.
We could sit in the pot.
Or we could sit on a large hollow log on the footbridge.
Oh, I couldn't think of it. I've never been to the footbridge with a man in my life.
Well, just stop.
I can't. Really, I have to change the social world.
Oh, well then meet me there in 15 minutes.
No, not today. Maybe tomorrow.
My dear little librarian, you start piling up enough tomorrow, you're going to find yourself collecting nothing but a lot of empty yesterdays. Now, I don't know about you, but I would like to make today a day worth remembering.
So would I.
The footbridge, 15 minutes.
Footbridge, 15 minutes. Mother! What? I just told Professor Hill I'd meet him at the footbridge in 15 minutes!
Well, glory be in the saints be praised it works!
What the?
I've been using the think system on you two from the parlor.
Late.
But you said 15 minutes.
Well, I mean you're 26 years late. It took you all this time to get to the footbridge with a fella.
If you want to know the truth, it was almost longer.
Oh?
Halfway here and nearly turned back. I suppose I'm not the first to find it easier to think clearly rather than develop your salesmanship.
Now, surely you don't think I've been trying to sell you anything.
No! You've given me something. That's why I came. And I'm glad.
I don't recall giving you...
Oh, yes, you have. Something beautiful. That's why I came in. Don't please don't think that I think that I should expect much more. One can't expect a traveling salesman to stay put. I know there'll be many ports of call, and there'll be many more. That's no reason for me not to be grateful for what you will have left behind. For me.
Marion, I...
took my
and only bass, and I move on up and down the square. With 110 cornets right behind.
Oh, it's so refined, this line.
There were horns of every shape then. Good night, my someone. Good night.
Thank you.
No.
Are you a big liar?
Yes.
Are you a dirty rotten crook?
Oh, yes.
Let me go, you big liar.
No, no, not until I talk to you. Now listen, I'm bigger than you, and you're going to hear what I have to say. Stop wiggling. Stop wiggling. Okay. Good. Now, there's two things you're entitled to now. One, you're a wonderful kid. I thought so from the beginning. That's why I wanted you in the band. You quit moping around.
What band?
I always think there's a band, kid.
What, the other thing I'm entitled to know?
Well, actually, you know, my second thing isn't any of your business.
I've been here a couple of birthdays.
So you don't believe him?
Sister, you believe him?
I believe everything he ever said.
But he promised us.
I know he promised us. It all came true, just like he said. The lights, the flags, the colors.
Where's all that?
The way every kid should have walked around the office. And look, the master. And you, and all the parents.
Does Mama wish he never hung for the city? Well, you can go too.
Now go, girl, please.
I can't go.
Why not?
Well, for the first time, I got my foot on the door.
There was
him step forward.
at you all, standing there like a coat of Shropshire sheep. Have you people forgotten how you bought expensive uniforms, technical instruction books, and high-priced band instruments? Have you forgotten the clear understanding and warranty that your kids would be taught to play in a band? Well, where's the band? Where's the band?
Okay.